My name is Christina Ales, and I work at Atlanta Medical Center here off of Boulevard, right in the center of the city. I am an emergency nurse, trauma nurse, and I also do rapid response.
Okay, Christina, what are you currently doing in the fight against coronavirus?
Currently, every day, go in, we do a huddle, talk about how things are changing because the virus is changing every day and the way that we go about treating it and how we're seeing patients changes. We have huddles in the morning. The teamwork's been phenomenal. I couldn't ask for a better team. Our management's behind us. Our president of the hospital's behind us. I feel very lucky and very blessed.
What's a typical day like for you now versus before the COVID-19 outbreak?
If I'm not at work, I spend most of my day with my dog. And if not, especially during these months, it's usually Atlanta United season. But due to the pandemic, haven't been able to do that except for once. Typical day at work, get in there and just go for it. It's a lot, depending on how it looks in the emergency department. And my job is to go around and check those patients and look for signs and symptoms of sepsis and coronavirus patients. I check their x-rays and I check lab work.
Some of the personal sacrifices that you've had to make during this entire outbreak.
So at the beginning, my first personal sacrifice was my dog. I wasn't sure if his daycare was going to be available. So, and he's my everything. He's my support. But he stayed at my parents. It also hurt a lot that I couldn't see my family. They live in Tennessee. And then not being able to see my friends. It's really those outlets outside of work that keeps me going. But it just kind of hurts a little bit that I can't see everybody. But I also know that I'm doing a service to our state and to everyone who's here.
Christina, how much pride do you take in the work that you're doing every day?
I've wanted to be a nurse forever. I love what I do. I couldn't imagine doing anything else. It means the world to me. I love serving, and it's actually kind of strange to me to think that people call us heroes or first responders. To me, it's strange just because I never thought of myself that way. This is just something I truly love to do. I love helping people in Atlanta, especially because this is my home.
Well, you did bring up the fact that you love Atlanta United.
I do.
You're a sports fan, so why do you like Atlanta United so much?
So I've been there since the beginning. I started as a Chattanooga fan because my family lives in Tennessee. And then Atlanta United played them in 2017, I believe, in February. And I was like, I have my own hometown team. That's amazing. And this is a silly correlation, but like, I mean, the teamwork goes the same way with us. Like when they have to go, when someone in the back has to go forward, someone in the front has to go back.
And do you notice anyone that popped into this chat just now?
No.
You swipe it to the right, maybe?
Swipe it to the right. Oh my God! What?
How are you?
Oh my God! Hi.
I loved your last answer. I couldn't have said it better myself.
Thank you.
Yeah. How are you, Christina? Yeah, I love you too.
I'm great. I'm trying not to cry. This is
no.
Oh my God. Hi.
Yeah. Well, I just wanted to kind of Zoom bomb this meeting just to say thank you on behalf of myself, your dog, Atlanta United. You know, we all just want to say thank you for what you do. It's extremely special. You know, everyone kind of comes out to Mercedes-Benz Stadium to come and watch us because they think we're special. But this is me coming to say hello because I think you're special and what you do is so amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. You're special.
Yeah.
You're one of like the best players, obviously, but also a team leader in what you do. So, I mean, I'm just going to channel you in when I go to work. Yeah.
Well, I just heard your answer and it sounds like you're probably a bit of a leader yourself. So I think
that
it's incredible what you do. And I know it's got to be so hard right now. It's hard on everybody, but hardest on you. So I want to say that you're doing a great job and keep it up. And we're all pulling for you. And we know that you're doing such great things right now.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I can't wait to see you guys back out there.
I know. We can't wait to be out there.
Yeah. Well, if you are ever on the field and you see the drummers, I'm part of La 12.
Okay.
And that's where I stand, so we'll be rooting for you.
Well, I'll be sure to look up to you next time we're out there, for sure.
Thanks. Yeah. Thank you. It's nice meeting you. Thank
Great you meeting too. You, Christina. I hope to see you again soon.
Yeah, for sure.
Keep up all the good work.
Thank you. I will.
Are you so surprised?
I'm just like, if you can't see my dimples, they're craters in my face right now. I'm just like, okay.
What was it like seeing Jeff Lorenowitz pop up there?
I was concerned I might have to go to the hospital because I think my heart skips a beat. But I've been dying to see him. And this is just, I don't know. I just want to like, I kind of want to go to work. That's kind of how I feel. I'm like, I'm going to go to work and I'm going to defeat the coronavirus and we're going back to games because that's what I'm going to do. That really just made my whole like year. 2020 has been rough. So...
Well, Christina, thank you so much. On behalf of 11 Alive, we wish you all the best. We thank you so much for what you're doing. You are a pioneer. Your spirit is amazing.
Thank you.
And it has been so refreshing to talk to you today, and I hope you enjoyed meeting Jet.
Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it. Thank you.